Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. Now I know I just did a video on this, but some people wanted to know what would happen if I used a spherical magnet instead of a cube-shaped magnet. Well, I didn't have a spherical magnet, but I did have some cylindrical magnets, and so I'm going to try it again using the cylindrical magnet. The idea here is that the magnetic flux will be more uniform, and perhaps it'll spin longer. So I've also attached some paper to it, mostly to see that it is indeed spinning or not, and also give me a way to hit it on that piece of glass there to spin it up under vacuum. But if we give it a little nudge under atmosphere, you'll see the air resistance is actually probably most significant here, so it slows to a stop fairly quickly. Let's pull out the air and see if that makes any difference.
Nope, nope, nope. Ah, dang it.
Okay, and we're back to a...
Really?
Alright, third time's the charm. We've got the magnet levitating the vacuum chamber under vacuum. Now I'm actually going to shine my laser on the edge of the paper, and this should produce a little bit of a thrust, almost like a rocket, as it burns the paper. So, here we go. Laser on. There we go, get it spinning. That's not bad. Now we can watch and see if it keeps going forever. Which of course it won't. Forever is a very long time. But you'd think that you could get it to go a little bit longer, you know. So, let's see if I can get it to go a little bit faster here. That's going pretty good. Almost looks like the golden snitch. But it's still slowing down about as fast as the cube-shaped magnet did, actually. Air resistance shouldn't be a thing, even though it's got these long arms. And yet, there it is, slowing down. Like I said in the earlier video, anytime you have a chunk of metal rotating in a magnetic field, it's going to slow down. It doesn't matter what shape it is. But there you are. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.